All right, you guys ready to be assertive? Yeah. I can't hear you. You're gonna make those people in line feel like complete fools. Yeah. Brass Knuckles is my name.
And Aaron Will Smith is mine.
And training ponies is our game. We welcome you to the first day of your new lives. Let me hear ya. I want to hear you stomp if you're tired of being a pushover.
I want to hear you stomp if you're tired of being a doormat.
Yeah. Stomp if you want to make nothing for this seminar. That's no joke, friends. Brass Knuckles is so confident that you will be 100% satisfied with Brass Knuckles' assertiveness skills that if you are not 100% satisfied,
you pay nothing!
Yeah! But I pity the fool who doubts Brass Knuckles' methods. You don't doubt me, do you?
No.
Yeah! Today, I welcome you to my assertiveness seminar, and I will share assertiveness techniques with you. But what is assertiveness? Assertiveness is a type of communication where you talk and you deal with a problem that you're facing and you're firm with your concerns. Say it with me, be firm with your concerns. Yes, it includes both listening and accepting what others say and expressing your own feelings, needs, and desires. And I am here to help you learn these assertive ways. To best practice being assertive, first you have to be your own leader and know yourself. To know yourself means to know both your talents and your weaknesses, and that takes courage. When Princess Twilight was taking her princess test, she accidentally swapped every pony's cutie marks around. This was a shock to every pony because her talents were what made them them. When Applejack said, "Modesty is not pretty, but it's what my cutie mark is telling me." That was her way of saying that she knew, through her self-awareness, that her talent wasn't right. Suddenly, their supposed talents were their weaknesses. The same goes for you. You have both talents and weaknesses. You have to admit that you may not be the best at talking to other people, right? You might have totally embarrassed yourself in the past, but you know what? Don't sweat it. You Pegasi, I see a couple of wings, right, Pegasi? Have you heard the quote, "Don't block the sunshine of life's today with the clouds of life's yesterday"? Get over your fears and doubts. You can do it. You're better than that. And you know what? We are here to make sure that you are confident in yourself and are ready to attack the day. Let me hear you say it. Attack the day. Louder.
Attack the day.
I welcome you to Brass Knuckles Assertiveness Seminar. We are joined today by my counterpart in compassion,
Iron Will Smith.
Yeah! Let's hear it for him. We are also joined today by my goat companion. Everyone meet Dandy.
That should be fun.
You're a handsome fellow. Come on.
There we go. Thank you.
Baby steps.
Volunteers and goats don't take no for an answer. So, what about me? I'm going to let you know about who I am and how I came to be an assertiveness ace. Years ago, when I was just a tiny brass nugget. I know. You're so cute. I love to wear these awesome hoof warmers. Look at them.
That's Gucci.
The neon colors, bright, happy, and warm, made me feel so confident and ready to attack the day. And one thing that I loved is wearing them to school. And of course, as Minotaur, you have to run with the herd every day for hours on end. But then I met Steel Wool, and she was a bully. And Steel Wool, every time she saw me with my awesome socks and hoof warmers, she was like, "I can't believe what you're wearing. Seriously? I don't know why you walk out of the house like this. You are such a waste of air. I don't even know why you bother to breathe. Yes, that was steel wool. And over time, that confidence that I had in wearing my awesome boot warmers slowly eroded into a red, hot, seething ball of anger. Until one day, there it was. I hit her. And I'm not physical, right? Or I didn't mean to be. And it was so quick that we didn't even stop running. No one noticed that I had just lashed out in anger and hit steel wall. And of course, she was all like, whoa, hold on a second. But because no one stopped, because no one said anything about the bullying that I lived through every day with my herd, I had the cloud of bullying over my head for the rest of that time. But then, one day, I got a letter to Assertiveness Academy, which is awesome!
It's great.
Oh my God, it's the best school for being assertive. And so I went up, grabbed all of my boot warmers and my neon-colored socks, and I said, hey, I can be myself. I can be who I want to be. Except, everybody else wasn't wearing neon boot warmers. In fact, we mostly wore uniforms. So before anyone noticed, I threw them away. That was my failure. I so wanted to be accepted by others that I couldn't accept myself. Accept yourself and all of your talents and interests, weaknesses and strengths, hobbies and quirks. Accept yourself. It was years later that I realized I still liked these hoof warmers. It didn't matter what anyone said to me. There is no use in being accepted by others if you don't accept yourself. Say it with me, accept yourself. Yes. You have to accept yourself and be comfortable with who you are. It was years later that I realized that I still liked them. And I brought them up. That's why I have them today. I learned who I am and what I love, and it doesn't matter what anyone else thinks. Accept yourself. That's why I'm here today. I don't want any of you to go through what I did. And if you did, it's okay. There are tons of other people here that have also been bullied and gone through rough times in their lives. And I know it's corny, but that phrase, it gets better, it will get better. For me, it took 10 years. And while a Minotaur's life is long, 10 years is still a long time to learn to accept yourself. So while you're here, take that message to heart. Accept yourself, and you can be assertive and confident too. That is why I'm here today. Accept yourself. Say it again.
Accept yourself.
Louder.
Accept yourself.
That's right. You are awesome no matter who you are.
Yeah. You better be tweeting about this seminar.
So enough about me. Let's talk about you. I am so glad that you all are here instead of the late opening ceremonies. And I want you all to become assertive. First of all, who's here at Bronycon for the first time? Oh my God, welcome! Applause!
Thanks for coming!
All right, which of you have been here for two Bronycons? Keep them up for three.
Eight.
Four. Five. All right, you get a sticker! Woo! Go! Sticker!
Come
on, Danky!
But it helps.
There's a reason we call him Danky. That's why he's going to sell.
All right, do you have anybody from another country?
It sort of helps, but...
Where are you from?
The band.
Taiwan. Excellent, welcome! She gets a sticker too. Woohoo! Thank you for coming so far just to see Brass Knuckles and I and Will Smith in person. That's great. And children, do you have any children in the audience? They're probably...
We're all kids at heart, that's why we're
here. They're probably in the activity area, unfortunately. But have you seen some of the activities they're doing? They've got the voice actors coming in, they got all kinds of cool, like, projects and stuff, and I'm like, I'm gonna go to the kids' But unfortunately, I'm no longer a brass nugget.
Yeah.
I know. But I'm here, and I'm going to help you to feel more confident. Yeah! And one way that we are going to make everybody that's in line or at opening ceremonies jealous is I want you to get your phones out right now. Go to the social media of choice. Let's do this. Get your phones out. We have hashtags.
Oh, these pants are tight.
We have hashtag brass knuckles MLP, all one word. Hashtag brass knuckles MLP, all one word. And hashtag Bronycon moments. Let's show them that this rocks. And while you do that, we are going to do some selfies. Let's go, Iron Man.
He went to go to the marketplace.
Oh my god, I can't do it.
Myself.
Oh, yes. Oh my god, bring it up,
give her a sticker.
He responded back. I heard him respond back. He said this is.
It's
10.
Okay, this is great. What's your name?
I'm Lachlan.
Lachlan, round of applause for the selfie stick. Let's see this go. Well, I will get my actual message ready because unfortunately my phone is possessed.
Okay. Let's see if Sun did it properly. Who's nobody else did yet.
Sun is
the
staff. Oh, yeah. Jeez. For those coming in, hashtag brass knuckles, MLP. That's okay, I have to do my message here. And we can take our time because people are still in opening ceremonies.
Hey, you guys got plenty of time because we were supposed to be delayed by 20 minutes, so you get a 20-minute extended panel.
Yay. We have much bonus material to
I know, there you go.
Okay, let's turn around. Let's see how this goes.
They're on their phones, so.
Now you guys
selfie
can do
stick!
But. Wait. That's amazing. I love this thing. So there's tons of ways that we can share our message with you. Yeah. Now that we've gone over some of the introductions, we're going to show you how assertiveness rules. But before we do that, we have some rules of engagement that we want to go over. First off, these rules that we're going to share with you are rules that everyone in this room is going to share while we go through our scenarios, and also technically really in the real world you should follow them too. So number one, while Iron, Will Smith, and myself are here to make you a better you, we are not trained professionals. So if you really need help, please seek it from the pros, counselors. You just need to see a doctor, do that. And if you want advice, we can give you advice, but...
You want to know how to cook an egg? I can tell you how to cook an egg.
You do it over easy? Yeah. I like it just a little bit.
There's another joke, but I can't say
it. Iron Will Smith. Seriously, every time I bring him up here. Okay, so the first rule is that we are not trained professionals. The second rule is participation! As you know, Iron Will Smith loves his volunteers. He does. And of course, Danky loves pulling volunteers up on stage. We will have volunteers. And remember that if you get called up, we're trying to help you become a better you. So, when volunteers are called, you will make your way on this side of the stage, minding the amazing sound system, and taking the stairs. Do not climb up here, or I will push you off. Take the stairs. So, do we have any Fluttershy's in the audience? I will take you. Come on up. Welcome, everybody. Front row, please. We'll take are you a Princess Big Mac too?
I'm glad you guys immediately sound funny. That's what we've been telling
you. Okay. Stand over here.
Okay.
And talk into Iron Will Smith's mic right there. Can you turn around, face the audience? And what is your name?
I am Michael Norman Strakowski.
Michael, where are you from?
Connecticut.
Welcome! Thank you for coming up on stage. So as we talk about participation, first participants, right? So Fluttershy has taught us an important lesson about saying no. Do you know what that is?
No means no.
What? Exactly. Say it with us! No means no. So if you really don't want to come up on stage, you can say no. And in the real world, if you really don't want to do something, no means
no.
That's right. Nobody ever should say that no doesn't mean no. And if they do, you should not hang out with them. And if it gets bad, you can tell on them, I promise. Let's hear it for our volunteer. You get a keychain. Excellent. This way. Thank you so much. All right. So it's not tough. And one of the things about our third rule is that we are all here because we're friends. We want to have fun in the name of friendship. We want to learn to be assertive together. So no matter what happens here, if you are nervous, if you are shy, if you are going to be stepping out of your comfort zone to get up on stage, do it here, because we're all friends. And this is a comfortable, safe environment to get out of your comfort zone. So remember that. It may be awkward, but don't worry, it'll be just fine. We are all here to support you, and we are all friends, and we are here in the name of friendship. Yes? And because of that, because before the show started, we did introductions, everybody here should have made a new friend. All you have to do is turn and say hello. And that's it, friends! It's awesome!
Did you get
yes.
That?
Okay. And that's why I want everybody to sit in the front, too. Nobody should be alone unless you want to. Okay. And I will tell you, at times I'm an introvert and I want to be alone, too. Okay. It's okay to have alone time, but it's also really good to have friends, right?
Yes.
Yeah, right here. Bang! All right, so we've gone over the rules of engagement for this seminar. And now one thing that we're going to do is talk about assertiveness after some water. We need some water for Iron Will Smith?
I got some in my bag.
We'll have someone to bring it to him. Oh. We are VIPs here. That's right. Do you like my swag? Attack the day. You can find a link to buying swag like this, shirts, merch, bags, on askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com. There's a link to where it is. Excuse me. All right, so assertiveness. What is assertiveness? Thank you. Round of applause. What is assertiveness? As I said earlier, I'm going to repeat this definition because as you learn more about it, it'll make more sense. So assertiveness is a type of communication that deals with a problem, if you have a problem, and it's used to defend your space. It's about being firm with your concerns. Say it with me. Be firm with your concerns. Right. It includes both listening and accepting what others say, and expressing your own feelings, needs, and desires. And that's why we're here to help you. To best practice being assertive, first, you have to know about how it works. And one of the things that assertiveness is big on is respect. As I said earlier, we're all friends here, we need to respect each other. No means?
No.
Yes. Brass Knuckles likes to say, seriously, I'm Will Smith. To be an assertiveness ace, respect the personal space. And I think the A is turned out here. This was a big phrase. All right, say it again. To be an assertiveness ace, respect the personal space. Right. Assertiveness rests on the foundation of respect for other people. And to go over an example of that, we're going to need another volunteer. Who's it going to be, Danky? All right. Yes. All right. Come on down. I love your socks, by the way. Geez, it's something like I had. All right, this way. And you're going to stand right in the middle. Okay, what's your name?
JC.
JC. Round of applause for JC. All right. JC. Hi. How's it feel when we stand this close to you?
I'm gonna smoke for the whole day.
How does it feel?
Invading.
It feels invading. Why is that? To be an assertiveness ace, respect their personal space. When we stand too close to you, we are getting in that personal space which everyone has. Some call it a boundary, or comfort zone, or an aura. When you get too close, you make people feel uncomfortable.
No.
I'm going to walk towards you, and you tell me when it feels right, okay?
He sent me.
Okay, now reach out to me. Okay, look at that. It's about an arm's length distance. Most people in this country say that an arm's length distance apart is where they start feeling weird. Do not get closer than that unless you are a close friend. In order to do that, then you are an assertiveness ace and respect their personal space.
He'll be here.
All right, so you know that.
Well, he'll probably be here.
Now,
because
we're friends now.
I guess I misunderstood it.
So now let's pretend we're friends and we're friends.
This is just a good friend.
No, 415 is his wife.
Right, but I think he just said that's a good friend.
Good friend
of
his.
So,
I don't know. I'm just here for a little bit. I messed up this morning.
Who are you?
I needed my camera for the yard
today.
This is
weird, right?
And I was afraid of that, and a good thing I'm
seriously, Danny. Okay. So what happens because we say,
to be an assertiveness ace, respect their personal space.
What you should do, Danky, is if you're a weirdo and you want to join a group and you don't know them, say, hey, my name is Brass Knuckles. Is it okay if I join you? Is it okay if you join us? Or you say, hey, I'm new here. Is it okay if I join your party? Yeah, that's cool. Yeah. So when you ask to join, first of all, that gets rid of the creepiness. Second of all, if they say yes, you have new friends. So here's the other thing, right? So if we're in a group and we see him, and he just doesn't, he's shy, he doesn't know that he should introduce yourself. If it's a private conversation, we can say, excuse me, this is private, can you go on? He should listen. And if he doesn't, that's when it's okay, say it again. And if he doesn't, talk to security, tell someone it's weird, because no one should be in your personal space. To be an assertive ace, respect your personal space. Or, if we're cool, he seems pretty suave.
He's got cool hair.
You know, hey, why don't you come join us? What's your name? Danky. That's how you get over the weirdos that stand near you and don't say anything, all right?
So don't just assume you're a weirdo.
Thank you for volunteering. All right, round of applause. Good job, Danky. Thank you. So that's one way that we respect their personal space. Now we're going to go through in a scenario, because Personal space is not just how close you stand to someone. It also includes an appropriate emotional distance as well. If people have values and beliefs, we need to respect their beliefs too. Some problems may be caused by their personal values and not necessarily because they were getting too close to you. Here's an example. I remember when Cranky Doodle came to town, riding on a pony. All right, he wanted to be alone, right? But one of the things that happened is that Pinkie Pie wanted to welcome him. We got some Pinkie Pies here, right? A couple Pinkie Pies. Pinkie Pie wanted to welcome him and be his friend, and it was so awesome, we're going to be friends forever. And what was Cranky Doodle doing?
Leave me alone.
Leave me alone? Waste of your time. Why do you want to be my friend? Get out of here. Now that was Cranky's belief. He wasn't trying to be mean. He wanted to be alone. But Pinkie Pie thought that he was hurting her. Pinkie Pie wanted to help, but help is only help if it's perceived as help. Cranky didn't think she was helping. He thought she was in his personal space, and that was not the way for Cranky. So instead, Cranky said that it was a waste of time and hurt Pinkie Pie's feelings because Pinkie Pie didn't know that was just who he was. Guys in the back row, come on up. Seriously, everybody in the front row, my goat helper, thank you, will guide you to open seats in the front.
That's
come
a cool
on
shirt.
In, guys.
I got
come
that shirt.
In. Oh, look it up. Be assertive, you guys!
Of all the times when the flag right. Trying to get here, it's after that.
Seriously, let's tell them what's going on. Attack the day, say it louder. Attack the day, come on, attack the day. So how did Pinkie Pie attack the day after all that? Well, she learned from Cranky. Come on up, everybody let him in. We got tons of space. Pinkie Pie learned that Cranky wanted to be alone. And then after that, she didn't have her feelings hurt anymore. It didn't matter what they were saying because Cranky was just being who he was. Once she respected that, it didn't hurt as much. So sometimes when people seem mean, they may actually just be defending their personal emotional space. Pinkie Pie learned there are tons of different ways to make friends and tons of different kinds of ponies out there. She learned that some like to be left alone, and that's fine too. Come on down, grab a seat.
You okay, buddy?
Fine. No problem. Yes.
Oh, really?
All right, engineer, famous man. Okay, so Pinkie Pie learned that there are many different kinds of friends and many different ways to express friendship. Hi, guys! Some ponies like to be left alone, and that's fine, too. So because of that, she respected his personal space with regard to emotional personal space. Now again, for you newcomers, to be an assertiveness ace,
respect their personal space.
Yes. We're going to need another volunteer to go through another scenario. Danky, pick a volunteer. Something that you like. So I'm going to try to tell her who's your best princess.
Best princess, a title has to do with how good the ruler actually is.
No, no, you don't. You think that she needs to change her mind.
You need to change your mind because you're wrong.
Yeah, exactly. So, hey, guys, have you seen this on Facebook before?
Yes. This happened to me at the airport. Somebody got personally offended that I did not like Luna.
Huh?
And got all of it in my face.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry.
No, that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. Don't apologize, defend your rights! I love you guys! I see new people, come on down! We all sit in the front in this seminar. If not danky, my goat will get you. So we have two opinions on who is best princess, but who is right? Everyone is right to be an assertiveness ace! Respect their personal space. If you respect these arguments and realize that this is a problem caused by beliefs and values, and you accept their values and accept that yours are different, arguments should not happen. However, most of the world has not gotten this message, so share the love. Thank you for volunteering. Round of applause. Welcome, everybody. You gotta come to the front in this seminar. Danky, you are working full-time on these people. Oh my goodness. Because we've gotten so many people, you all hear from the opening ceremonies? Okay, we have some rules of engagement for this seminar. The first rule is that while Iron Will Smith and myself are here to help you to become a better you, we're not trained professionals. Not yet. So if you need help, real advice, seek it from counselors and pros, okay? The second is, yes, we are having volunteers, and it may be weird, but don't worry, we are in a safe environment. If anyone laughs, that's okay, because one of the things that we're gonna do is say, we've probably been in your shoes. We're not teasing you, and we're not bullying.
Get it?
Bullying?
That's right, no bullying allowed in this seminar. Nobody should be bullied. And if you see something, remember, speak out, say something, and accept yourself, right? Accept
yourself.
Accept yourself, yes.
Love yourself.
And to be an assertiveness ace.
Respect your personal space.
Awesome. So we've gone through the idea of emotional personal space, and we've gone through the idea of physical personal space. We've gone through our catchphrases. I think we have, yeah, pick up the firm one. One more catchphrase for those of you that are late. Assertiveness is a type of communication that is firm with your concerns. Be firm with your concerns. And by doing that, you're going to express your needs and in your personal space and help people to understand where they are. So now we've gone over some examples. We had a couple Fluttershy's. We've got a couple new Fluttershy's. Awesome. When Fluttershy came up here, she taught us that no, our Fluttershy volunteer, taught us that no means?
No.
Yes, no means?
No.
Yes. Wait, no, no, I don't. Okay. So Fluttershy taught us no means no. And Fluttershy has always been shy and sometimes submissive. Submissive is at the low end of what we call the assertiveness spectrum. So think about when ponies are shy, you want to get a little, you know, hold up together. When you're shy, you tend to not speak your needs. And if you think you speak your needs, if you talk about your assertiveness ace, then respect the personal space. And one thing that we say is assertive deeds meet your needs. All right? You want to talk about what you need to be comfortable, to be happy, and to make sure that no one is in your space. So when submissives like Fluttershy speak, they're shy, quiet, no matter the emotion behind it. You gotta look really nice for it. There you go. You gotta be, they're often shy and quiet. Saying something like, well, I don't like that. It's not the same as saying, I don't like that. You hear the difference?
Yeah.
They always speak shy and quiet, but they're not firm with their concerns. Be firm with your concerns. And they're too quiet and they don't necessarily talk about their needs. And often when shy ponies speak, they don't make eye contact. Iron Will Smith likes to say,
don't be shy. Don't be shy. Look him in the eye.
That's right. Don't be shy. Look him in the eye. They also tend to put others' needs in front of their own when given the choice of fight or flight, they'll choose flight and run away. And they also are sometimes in abusive relationships.
On the other far extreme side of that is the aggressive folks. Aggressive folks tend to put their needs before others. They can be abusive, rude, sarcastic, and dominating, and not in a fun way.
Every time iron goes dead. Come here, dude. That is the wrong kind of abusive.
Wow.
All right. But we don't want to be abusive.
No.
We don't want to be aggressive. We don't want to be shy. We want to be in the middle, which is being assertive. Assertiveness is being firm with your concerns. Again, be firm with your concerns without domination. And it includes expressing your own feelings, needs, and desires. We say, assertive deeds
meet your needs.
Yes, assertive deeds meet your needs. So when you're in the middle, then you are expressing yourself in a way that meets your needs. So what happens if the needs are unmet? Fluttershy said, "You make me lose, I blow my fuse!" Is that even solid, Fluttershy? Okay. She knew that sometimes that anger can add up. The same happened for me. For those of you that came in late, I was bullied when I was a little brass nugget. I was, and it took me a long time to learn to be assertive. And one of the things that I learned about that is that if I don't express my needs, that anger will add up until one day you explode verbally, physically. Physically. And sometimes you hurt yourself. And none of those are good. None of those are good. You have to accept yourself, know who you are, and express your needs using these assertiveness techniques, right?
Yeah.
Express your needs and not go through these explosions of anger or hurt. You can find the middle ground, which is being assertive. Dave, I want you to hold this. You can hold this one.
Gotcha.
And we need a volunteer to come up here and hold the last one. Yes, please, come on down.
Let's go.
And you can stay in the front or come in the back. Pass this one down. So we've gone over these phrases for those of you that are new. And what's your name?
Ashley.
Ashley! So this is what we've gone over so far. First, Danky, accept yourself. Say it with us.
Accept yourself.
You are awesome. Accept yourself.
Accept yourself.
Yes, Ashley. Be firm with your
concerns.
Be firm with your concerns. Without domination, don't be mean, but say what you mean. Because assertive deeds
meet your needs.
Right? And
to be in assertiveness space, respect their personal space.
Personal space is how close you stand to somebody, and it's also based on what you believe. Okay, you can put these down, and we will get Ashley.
Real loud.
A nice swag volunteer teaching. Round of applause. So we've gone over the three types on the assertive spectrum, from shy to aggressive, and then to assertive. Now, if we want to be assertive, what do we do? How do we do it? There's a way to express your needs by saying what you are doing and what is affecting you that will help you to express your needs. Brass Knuckles likes to call this the safe statement. When you need to meet your needs, play it safe. By talking about your problem in terms of what is making you have an issue, describe the specific act or situation that is impacting you. Talk about what it is that's going on that's making you upset for whatever reason it is. Talk about how it makes you feel. The impact of whatever is making you upset. Talk about how it makes you feel. When people understand why you're upset, it helps them to understand why what they're doing is not right with you. And then describe the effect of whatever it is, and not only how it makes you feel, but what the consequence or the impact of that is. The safe statement, S-A-F-E, specific act, feelings, and effects. Play it safe by making a phrase that uses these points. In the real world, you may have heard this as SBI. Anyone? Situation, behavior, and impact. Same thing, but safe is easier to remember, don't you think?
Yes.
Play it safe by describing these things. We'll go through an example so you know what a phrase is. And for that, we'll need a volunteer. Okay. We've got a volunteer. Round of applause. Thank you for volunteering and find the poster. We should have a lot of phrases here. Okay, welcome. What's your name? This is Annika, everybody. Thank you. So we're going to go through a scenario, and you're going to try and figure out what the safe statement is. Think about when the Breezies first came to Ponyville. Any fans of the Breezies? When Sea Breeze came here with all of his big Breezy friends, they were taking their time getting home, and Sea Breeze started freaking out and yelling at every Breezy to hurry up. Fluttershy had to use an assertiveness statement to help them out, she had learned from our seminar. Yeah? And so she used a safe statement, and I'm going to repeat it a couple times, and all you have to do is figure out the pieces. So, she said to help Sea Breeze out,
Sea Breeze, I understand your feelings are hurt, but it's hard for them to hear you. When you're shouting and being mean, they feel upset because they can't focus. It's not that no Breezy listen, but that the message doesn't get across.
So I'm not going to flutter her voice. She says, just keep trying. So I'm going to say it again in my voice, and you can tell me what's going on. So the first two letters of SAFE are?
S-A.
S-A. Yes, you passed the first quiz. The specific act that's causing the problem. So she said, Sea Breeze, I understand your feelings are hurt, but it's hard for them to hear you. When you're shouting and being mean, that's a specific act. When you're shouting and being mean, they feel, which is the letter? Yes! They feel upset. And what's the last letter? E! All right, safe. Specific act, feelings. So they feel upset because they can't concentrate. It's not that no Breezy listened, but that the message didn't get across. So she used this format, this safe sentence, to help explain the problems that the Breezes had, right? Yes, so say it again. Use the mic. What is play it safe?
Wait, okay. Specific act, yes. Feelings, and effects.
Yay! There we go. All right, thank you very much. You can head back down this way.
Thank you.
Round of applause. Some other panel went over time. But we've gone over these ideas, okay? We've gone over talking about to be an assertiveness ace, respect their personal space. Be firm with your concerns. Accept yourself. Assertive deeds, meet your needs, and play it safe. Come on in! Now that we've gone over these things, the basics of how to speak up, be assertive, and not be creepy when you're in somebody's personal space, we're going to open it up for questions on the material that we've covered so far. So if you have questions, we're going to give the mobile mic to Danky. And you can bring the mic to people with questions. There's Fluttershy up front. Let's do it her first. Danky.
Okay. Do you think it's important to differentiate no means no and yes means yes regarding consent in any situation?
Did everybody hear that? Do you want to answer?
The difference between no means no and yes means yes when you're talking about consent.
Yes. Okay. I cannot stress this enough. No means no and yes means yes. If it's no, leave it be. If it's yes, go for it. That it's literally as simple as that. No means no, yes means yes. All right? So it's like if you're at a stoplight. You don't go if it's red.
Was that kind of the question?
Well, oh, I'm sorry. I was trying to make a point for everybody.
So I think it's more of like yes means yes is more about making sure that you ask if that's okay with
yeah.
you.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, you know, oh that's what you meant. I'm
yeah.
sorry. Yes.
So like if they don't say no, that doesn't mean it's okay.
Yes. Oh, that's a very good point. Just because you don't say no doesn't mean it's a yes.
Right.
Okay.
One of the things that we talked about at the beginning of the seminar is also that you need to introduce yourself. You need to be able to ask people if you can join them if you're in a group. Because sometimes you may not be welcome, and sometimes you may. But the only way to do that right is to be able to say, hi, can I join you? Hi, can I do this? Is this a thing? So that's really, really important. And I know that a lot of people don't understand it, but that's why we have to share that message. It's a very unfortunate truth. Does that help? Thank you very much for your question. Round of applause.
Not a question, but just a comment. I think it's also worth pointing out that being bullied or coerced into saying yes is not consent.
That is
and if you feel pressured, woohoo! And if you feel pressured to say yes, then it's not a real yes.
Oh my god, yes.
It's not a real yes.
And again, if you see bullying, say something. Whether it's you that's being bullied or someone else, we have to take responsibility for everyone. Everyone. Thank you. In the blue, the Luna gentleman. The double princess. Thank you for attending.
What would be your advice on like learning how to take criticism?
How to take criticism. We actually will not have time to go through that in this seminar, but one of the most important things to do is to think about how to listen better. And there are books and there are articles on this, and the idea is when somebody criticizes you, the best way to deal with criticism is to listen, to observe. I want to get this out for you guys, because I brought it as a backup slide.
We're always prepared.
Always prepared in Assertiveness Academy. We had to spend a lot of money on these things. All right. Listen to observe, not reply like Maude Pye. When Maude Pye listens, she takes everything with a grain of salt.
What you mean? Rock salt colors.
Damn it! Listen to observe, not reply like Maude Pye. Think about what people say. Internalize what they say. And don't take it to heart. Realize, oh, you said I'm a horrible person? Don't think that you're a horrible person just because they said it. Don't think that what you're doing is necessarily bad because it's bad. They may also be, if it's constructive criticism, they may be telling you what to do better in the future. And if you listen to observe, internalize what they're saying, but don't take it as offensive to your values. That will help you to understand, like Maude Pye, what's going on, think about it, repeat what they say, and make sure that if they're saying, you're a horrible person, say, you're saying I'm a horrible person, is that right? Ask them if what they're saying is really what they mean. Sometimes they may not. Sometimes they're just expressing their anger, they're venting, they're expressing their needs, and they may have been exploding too sometimes. So you have to understand that you need to make sure that they know what they're saying, and they need to know the impact of that criticism. If they're criticizing you, how about you make a safe statement and say, when you criticize me and say that I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing, it makes me feel worthless because I'm trying. What can I do to be better? If you tell them how that makes you feel, it will help them to understand what's going on with their behavior and how it impacts you. Does that help? And observe to reply. Like Maude Pye. Thank you so much. Question in the middle? Come on, Dick. All right.
Sometimes I'm afraid to say no because I'm afraid I'm going to be rude, and I've had people like blow up at me in the past for saying no to them.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any advice for dealing with that? Because I don't want to seem rude.
Okay. You can say your part too. So, saying no is very difficult because sometimes when submissives act, they will take others' feelings as more important before themselves. This was me for a long time.
You want to make sure that other people are happy. You don't want to offend them. You don't want to hurt them. And if that happens, you need to realize that sometimes you need to express your needs. You need to be firm with your concerns. You need to have the courage to say it and to understand. If you can't just say no means no, make it a safe statement. When you ask me this, it makes me feel uncertain because I really don't want to. I don't want to, and it's not you, I just don't feel comfortable. If you need to explain it further, you can say more than just no. Does that help? Thank you.
Also, if you put yourself out there, especially like we were going to go over like body language and like how I speak, the projection of my point, if you talk like you know what I say is what I mean, then it'll be way easier to get your point across.
That's right. Make sure that your voice also sounds firm. Sometimes there are actually voice coaches out there. If you speak shy and quiet, sometimes it's okay to ask for help. So practice making your voice sound stronger. By being firm with your concerns, you have to make it sound firm too. Thank you, Ayrosa. All right. How about from the outside area? Any questions on the ring? Okay. Any other questions? Yes, over there. Do it, Dickie.
Do it. Hey.
What do you do when you're trying to be assertive with someone, but they're being aggressive? And you're trying to express yourself in an assertive manner, but they're just exploding and going on and screaming and hollering.
Yes. Thank you. What do you do when you are trying to be assertive, but they just keep yelling at you? So, we have an example that we're actually going to get into a little bit, but we can do it right now. So imagine that Iron Will Smith and myself are dorm partners. He's in a room next to me, I'm sitting next to him. How many people are in college or have been in college, had roommates? Now, Iron Will Smith likes to party. He is playing his music super loud, and what's gonna happen? It's Thursday night, it's almost midnight, and I'm studying, and I have a test on Friday, and he's rocking out next door, and I'm going, oh my god, I need to study, I'm getting worried, I'm getting butterflies in my stomach, and I need to sleep, and he's being so loud. So what happens? If there is something like that, you can be submissive, and you can slip a note under the table, and under the door, and say, hey, here we go. And the problem is, if you're submissive and you send a note, he may or may not read it or care because he's aggressive right now, or it may make him angry. And you don't want to see Iron Will Smith when he's angry. Or you could be aggressive. So if you go up there and you're banging on the door, Iron Will Smith, turn that music down! That's when he could be angry too. And you don't want that. So if you're trying to be assertive about this example, and I say, and I write out this statement first to make sure that I know what it is, just in case I get nervous because they're very aggressive. Bring it with you. Say, hey, Iron Will Smith, when you are being loud this late at night, it makes me feel sick to my stomach and nervous because I have a test tomorrow. Now, if you are being aggressive back to me after the statement, you say, well, you don't care.
Well, I don't care.
Yeah. He's jamming. You don't care about me. He's got his rights to his music, right? So he's going to be aggressive. So one of the things that they say in the SBI, the Situation Behavior Impact, which SAFE is based off of, is that the first thing you should do when they continue to be aggressive is repeat that statement as many times as you need to. When you're loud and playing music this loud, and I have a test tomorrow, it really hurts my feelings because these grades mean a lot to me. It makes me feel nervous and sick to my stomach because if I don't get my sleep, I'm not going to do well. I might get expelled or worse. Harry Potter reference. Can you please make sure to keep your music down this late, especially on a Thursday night?
Well, when you put it like that, sure, yeah, I can play that.
So, try that a few times. That's one way to get through it, is to repeat the statement. Keep saying the impact, how it makes you feel, and why they need to respect your opinions. There's also many books and many articles on this that goes into different ways that you can reflect what they say. So if he says, well, I'm jamming, say, that's fine, but if he starts to yell at you being aggressive and he says, you have no right, you are nothing, then of course, that's a problem with their assertiveness. And you say, well, I understand that you're saying that I don't have a right, but one of the things to consider is that I have rights too. And you just have to work through it. I highly recommend that you read books on SBI. You won't find SAFE, but you will find SBI. And if you want to learn more about these techniques, you can find out more from my pages on askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com. You can also see inspirational quotes that I have written on askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com. I have said many times in the seminar that if you like what you're seeing, that's great. But if you are not 100% satisfied, you pay nothing! And even though you don't have to pay anything, there is a donate button on askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com where you can donate to have more shows like this. It's really cool the kinds of things you can learn about assertiveness. And we have a lot more that we didn't share with you today, but I'm getting signals from the back that we're still gonna have to cut it short. So one of the things that you can do is you can ask us at askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com. You can continue the discussion outside. I will be around all convention in my awesome swag. And we will help you to learn to be assertive, not just by how you talk, but how you look. Everybody, roll your shoulders back. Sit up straight and feel like your head is dangling from a string. If you look confident using body language, it will make you feel better. There are studies that say that up to 45% more confidence is built in your body by chemicals just by looking assertive. 45% more confident just by widening your stance, looking straight, and looking confident. You don't have to feel confident at first, but it will change the chemicals in your mind and make you feel confident and ready to attack the day. Let me hear you say it again. Attack the day. Louder.
Attack the day.
Stand confident. Look confident. Don't be shy.
Look confident.
That's right. Really? So, thank you. As you prepare for the crazy world outside of this door, try and remember to have an iron will. Have an iron will. Don't forget that no means no. Don't forget about the problems that you can be firm with your concerns about. Be confident in who you are. As you prepare for the harsh reality beyond these doors, remember to have an iron will. And don't be afraid to ask for help from friends or counselors. Read up. Look for help, and remember there are tons of other people that are also the same way that we are. Shy, nervous, not so assertive. But you can learn to be assertive using Brass Knuckles assertiveness skills. Come on, let's hear it. So, don't you pity the foal who didn't attend today? Look at all these empty seats. And speaking of poor, unfortunate foals, I admit that in the past, I was a shy one. I was bullied and they called me, well, a witch.
That's deceivers.
But you'll find that nowadays, I've mended all my ways. Repented, seen the light of assertiveness, and made a switch.
He's got being an assertiveness ace.
That's right. And unfortunately, no friendship is magic. It's a talent that all of us possess. And here lately, please don't laugh. I've used it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Poor, unfortunate foals, in pain, in need. This one wanting to be thinner. This one wants to get the girl. And do I help them? Yes, I do. These poor, unfortunate foals, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my seminar crying,
"Help me, press them, please."
And do I help them? Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Some pony wouldn't pay the price. And we quickly learned that no means
no.
Yes. Now you've taken what I say. And I hope after today, you're now proud.